No, people don't like to hear how to eat. People don't like to hear how to dress. And those are two things I've been teaching for quite a while. And a lot of people didn't like to hear those things. And prophecy or whatever, people love to hear those things. Mm-hmm. It won't be three times the size if we were talking about something people love to hear. But I'm not here to tell people things people love to hear. I want to reveal scripture to people. And I consider coming to a congregation pretty much speaking to the choir. And that's good. That's okay. But I'm going to talk a minute about street evangelism, because it's one thing to go to somewhere where people are coming to hear you listening about the word. But it's another thing to go to the street and take it to people that either don't know it or don't want to know it. And I used to have some feelings about that that have changed, and how to get out there and do it myself. So after we do this first talk, I'm going to do that second one, and want to encourage you to come on out there with us. It's really, it's changed my whole life, my whole spiritual life, my whole life on every level, just to get out there and share Yeshua with the world. It says believers, that's what we have to do. You know, and some people say, I didn't even get to the person, I'm talking about that already. But street evangelism, people say it's not for me, or it's not for everyone. And I agree it's not. But sharing Yeshua is for everyone. And we got to find a way to do that. And so we're going to talk about that in a little while, and hopefully encourage you to do so. But before that, Yah's giving me something that people want to hear even less than about dress and eating. So we're going to talk about this. And basically it comes down to this. My background, basically, I grew up in New York City, in a little town called Brooklyn. Anyone here from New York? Or no?
Lived there for 6 years.
Great. So we have a translator in the room tonight. If you don't understand anything I'm saying. But basically, both my parents are Jewish. That made me Jewish. And but we didn't grow up. I mean, they gave another level to the word secular. They were nothing to do with the scriptures or anything. The only connection growing up my parents had with the Bible was my mother would take off Jewish holidays just because she had a day off. And so I didn't know anything about anything. I grew up an atheist. And then when I was 19 years old, I got sick with something called inflammatory bowel disease, also known as ulcerative colitis and Crohn's disease. I got better by changing my diet, my lifestyle. But then I started to believe in something. I'm no longer an atheist. So I became... People will call it agnostic. I'll say New Age. I believe in everything, picking and choosing the best of everything. And then I was at a place teaching right after Passover one year in Michigan called Yahweh's Wellness Center. And it was the middle of the night, and there was a fellow that came out of the room, and he had a hat with my favorite number, 343, on it. And I'm working at the table, and I talk to you. I said, what is it? He goes, he's talking in your health talk tonight about praying and fasting. You know, the Bible says a lot about that. I said, no, it doesn't. And he said, have you ever read the Bible? I said, no. He goes, well, how do you know it doesn't? And we talked for about 2 hours. Me just trying to shoot down everything he was saying the Bible said that was for our benefit. And I told him, I'm going to prove him wrong. I'll read it to prove him wrong. And not only did I find about, you know, the Bible talks about health, but I found that it talked about a lot of things. I got through the first book, the book of John, and I accepted Yeshua as my Messiah. And I was confused. I'm like, but I'm Jewish. How could I follow Yeshua? And then I kept reading and found that he was Jewish. I said, this is going to be easy. I'm just going to do what he said to do. And then I went into churches to teach about health, and I was real confused because the only part of the Bible I knew was the red writing, the reading of Yeshua, what Yeshua was saying. But the churches were teaching different than what the Bible said. So I didn't have to unlearn Christianity, because I wasn't brought up in Christianity. And I just said, I'm reading the word of Yeshua, and this is how I want to live my life. I naturally gravitated into what's called the Hebraic roots or Messianic, or the truth movement, because I'm just following the word, you know, best we can. But, so the church isn't teaching that, and I saw that. So my ministry originally was to teach, see, the New Agers know about health, but they don't know about Yahweh. So the original, the health, they're really sick, the believers. They're just not following the scriptures. So I was going to teach the believers about health and the New Ages about Yahweh. But the more I spoke in church, I said, I got to teach the believers about Yahweh and the information he's saying. And it just